So they were not asking them for their money or their fortune or nothing at all. Just asking to show them, but they just closed their ears and...
No, you see, we are coming at cross purposes, let's say with the Christians. He says sin is inherited. We say no, sin is not inherited. Sin is acquired. From the word go, we are now a tug of war. He says sin is inherited. Everybody is a sinner. Everybody goes to hell. Unless you believe that Christ died for your sin. So number one, we say no, sin is not inherited. Right? Number two, he says Jesus is God. We say no, he's not God. He said Christ was crucified. He said no, wama kataluhu wama salabuhu. He's going to like you. He says God is the Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. You say, wala takulu thalasa. Don't say Trinity. Intahu khairan lakum. This is, stop it, it'll be better. You think anybody likes that? Anybody likes that? No. So you have to learn, huh? Look, that is the fact. Whatever he's telling is wrong, wrong, wrong. But now we have to find ways and means of getting at that fellow. And the best way is, ask him, where did you get this? He says, it's in my book. So let's have a look. What does he say? If you can humble yourself, let us see. Come on, let's have a look, man. Jesus is God? He said, yes. Did he say he's God? He said, yes. So where? Show me. In my lectures, in my debates, I'm telling the Christian, you show me anywhere in your Bible, anywhere, in any version of the Bible, where Jesus says, I'm God, I said, I'm prepared to accept him as God. If Jesus says, worship me, I'm prepared to worship him. I say, I don't speak for these people. For you, I can't speak for you. I speak for myself. Show me. Finish. The guy is stunned. No argument. I say, you show me and I'll accept. You say, it's not there. I say, you're asking me? Your book. You show me. Where Jesus says, I'm God, I'm prepared to accept him. Where he says, worship me, I'm prepared to worship him. So in other words, now because I know his book, I can offer him that. And now he's stumped in front of 2,000 people. The guy's stumped. Said, Christ died for my sins. He said, wait, how? Talk to him. Allah says, Kul hadu burhan. Ask him for his burhan. Allah is telling you that he hasn't got a leg to stand upon. That's as if the judge is telling you, go to town with the fellow man, smash him up, man. I know he's a liar, he's a liar, he's a liar. Go and make a mess of him. The judge is telling you. And you're not doing it. The judge is telling you, this guy is a liar, he's a fake, and you're doing nothing. You must go to town. Come, man, let us talk, let us reason together. That is the strength. See, you're speaking from strength. Now, come. I'm prepared to listen to you. What have you got? So that's what I'm showing you. Use his book. Allah says, Qul hatu burhanakum. Ask him for his burhan. He produced it, 11 different Arabic dialects. For you Arabs, 11 different Arabic dialects. What excuse you got now? In 2,000 different languages. I just come from Sudan. I went to the Sudan. They have done 40 different Southern Sudanese language, Bible. They are at war with the Dinkas in the south. The Dinka, they got 4 different Dinka dialects, Bible in 4 different Dinka dialects. But now you haven't learned the art. That guy comes from 10,000 miles. He learns the language of the native and converts him and strengthens him, uses the Bible as a textbook for teaching him literature. He's doing the job brainwashing the guy. And you're going to tell him, no, this is no good. It doesn't work. He's given it to you in your language. So we have to learn from the enemy to do the job. I don't know. I'm trying to learn from the enemy. Myself, to invent the wheel is not for me. I haven't got that energy. The time to invent the wheel, a new wheel. You know wheel? It's invented, man. Right? Whoever has take it and improve on that wheel. Don't start wanting to say, I'm going to make my own wheel. So I'm learning from the enemy. This is what he is doing. I said, right, if I do the same thing with my book, the Quran is there. There is a type of man, you talk about the Quran. There's a type of man, perverted transgressor. As soon as you open your mouth about the Quran, say, where did it come from? I said, no, it was revealed to the Holy Prophet Muhammad. Muhammad? How many wives did he have? He's making a mockery. Right? He spread his religion at the point of the sword. He forced people, stamped down people's throat. Fight. No, don't do that. I said, learn this judo. You know, use the force, of your enemy and you see, you go far better, longer, with less strength. You don't need that amount of strength if you use the strength of your enemy. This is next one, my son.
You said this book, Stand in the Corner and Smile, would solve a lot of problems. Do you think Muslims who are being persecuted and executed in Algeria, Muslims in Burma, Muslims in Kashmir, in Palestine, need this book for the solution? Do you think that is the true solution? And also with that, to extend from that question, brother, inshallah,
I have all your problems. Algeria, you have a problem. Kashmir, you have a problem. In India, we have a problem. In Palestine, we have a problem. Now, with this one pellet, with one this little pebble, you want to solve all the problems? No, I never claimed it. I said, this Jalut who's knocking at your door, this is how you can shut him up. This is how you can educate him. Because that guy is not going to wait till you solve all your problems. He's stealing your children in the meantime. In Algeria, he's stealing your children. In Kashmir, he's stealing your children. In Bangladesh, in Pakistan, in Indonesia, in Malaysia, all over the world here, man, it's a godsend opportunity for them to steal your children here. Aren't they coming and knocking at your door? So now, to me, I'm only telling you how to deal with this Jalut, the American, the British, the French, whoever it is, who's trying to steal your children. I said, now, this is how to fight him. You tell me how you're going to solve the problem in Algeria? I said, brother, there are better people than me there, Algeria. About Palestine, I said, there are better people than me to solve the problem of Palestine. I'm not here as a god to tell you solve all your problems. I'm only telling you, this guy here is trying to steal your children. This is how you can defend yourself. A one-day survival course. I want to give you a survival course against this enemy. And when you have time, I'll also tell the Algerians I'm supposed to go there and tell them something. And tomorrow, go tell them something. For everybody, I have something. But now, at the right place. Here, I'm going to tell you what you're going to do in Algeria. What am I? I'm wasting your time. And in Pakistan, in Kashmir, what you must do? In Indonesia, what am I doing? I said, can you do this? Yeah, if you fit in, okay. If not, inshallah, we'll carry on with this work. But now, this is just for the moment. Here, in your environment, I say you need this. In America, you need this.
Well, I didn't finish my question. I said, because for me, they haven't stolen our belief. They've stolen our system from us. That's what they've destroyed. But to take the question further, this book, saying it's different for Indonesia and all those countries, but what about this book for our rulers who claim to be Muslims, like Fahd, Sabah, Hosni Mubarak, Assad, because they are the biggest oppressors of Muslims and implementing the deen. Is this a solution, or is the Quran the solution? And fi sabilillah. That was my question, really.
So you see, my brother, to me, I feel you are a better man to change Fahd than me. You are a better man to change Mubarak than me. I take it that you speak Arabic.
No.
Well, learn Arabic. You see, learn Arabic, and I think you'll do a better job. You see, this is a world of specialization. You're specializing in something, aren't you, at school? What are you doing at present?
I'm doing Arabic and politics. I'm learning Arabic.
Right, there you are, in politics. You see, he's going into politics. That means you are equipping yourself, mashallah, for that field. I am not equipped. I was forced into this area, and in this area I have become an expert. So my expertise I'm now sharing with you, that's all, in this field. You tell me to solve all the world problems of the world. I said, no, I don't know, brother. I can't.
No, I'm not asking you to.
So I said, now, you say, this or that. I said, no. You be an expert in politics, you do that field. No, I'm serious. Look, no. If you can make people, right. You will read people's minds? Okay, you teach that science. I don't know. You say, look, first woman. I said, look, please leave me alone. This is all that I know. I'm showing you my weakness. In specialization, that's your weakness. If you are a specialist, you are right on top there, but in something else, you know nothing about. You are a doctor, medical doctor. You can't change a fuse, man. Fuse. But now, look at that. He didn't learn about changing fuse. That carburetor in the motor car, he can't adjust that. And you are a doctor, B-A-L-L-B. What kind of a donkey is this? I said, no, look, that's a different field. You are a doctor. I am a doctor in this field. If I can be of help to you in this field at the moment, this is all that I can do. I'm not going to take on the world because I know I'm committing suicide. I just want my soldiers. You are my soldiers. My soldiers, can my soldiers do this? That's all I'm going to give you. I won't tell you to pray five times a day. Somebody else must tell you that. You know, make tahajjud and make ishraq and read subhanallah so many times. That's not my job. Me, I said, can you do this? So that you are my soldier to do this job. That's all. The rest of it, there's somebody else telling you your beard must be standard size. This Nasara clothes you are wearing, me too. You say, look, you must make Islamic clothes. That's not my line. I said, let the other guy do that. I'm not coming in his way. I won't come in your way. You know, when you talk politics, political science, what you know and what you understand and how to do things, I will follow you. I will follow you. See when you give the lead. But for the time being, this is all that I can do to help people.
Today there is a new Holy Trinity. Isn't the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit?
Yes.
It's capitalism, democracy, and freedom. This is the new Holy Trinity that we see in the world. We talk about Christianity, but from my limited experience as somebody who's a student and who actively partakes in the Islamic society, people don't care about Christianity. If you look in the world today, it isn't Christianity that's been implemented. It's capitalism, democracy, or freedom. So I think the real problem that should be addressed are these problems, because as Muslims, we have a stigma. We get upset when we hear a Muslim has become Christian. But there are many millions of Muslims who become Democrats, who become secularists. We don't make a big deal about this. So I feel our energies will be better put to use if we tackle these problems. It's because it's capitalism today that's the dominant force in the world today.
This, my son, I agree with you 100%. You see, you are the fittest guy for that job. You want to pass the buck onto somebody else. This idea is what you gave now about democracy and communism and all that. You are the fittest guy for that unholy trinity you talked about just now. Right? But now you want to find somebody, a scapegoat, somebody to do the job. You are a coward. Everybody, I'm telling you, now when you come with an idea, any idea, new idea, you say, Mr. Didat, why don't you do this, like this, like that? I said, my son, Allah chose you for that. If he inspired you, what he inspired you with, he has chosen you to do the job. But you coward, you, please don't take offense. I said, you coward, you look at Sheikh Dahran, why doesn't he do that? Ahmad Didat, why doesn't he do that? You are a coward. You are the right person to do the job. But you want to shirk that responsibility. Say, you want to pass it on to me? I said, please, man, I'm telling you my weakness. I'm telling you, I have no knowledge about what you're talking.
No, I'm asking you not to confuse the issue with Christianity, because no, Christianity is not the issue.
Did any Christian come and knock at your door?
No, alhamdulillah.
Where do you live?
I live in London.
Huh?
I live in London.
Where about in London?
North London.
Huh?
North London.
In an ivory tower?
No.
Look, you are like the invisible man. Maybe the Christians can't see you.
Maybe they're scared of me.
Maybe that. So in other words, they know that this guy here is a greater devil than us, so he keeps them away from you. But our people, we know. They're harassing our people all over. All these books that I was showing you, see what they're doing? Christ gave the key in your hand. See this? Christian witness among Muslims. See this guy here? Better Muslim looking than most of us. Huh? K.K. Alawi is the key to us in search of assurance. He's a murtad, he wants to make you a murtad. I haven't shown you all. What I've got here, you want to catch your daughters now. See this? You want to catch your daughters now. She may never know a Christian. She may never meet a Christian. But you can write to her about God's love. Either you know what's going on around you or you don't. See, like an ostrich with the head in the sand, you don't know what I'm telling you, that the house is on fire, they're stealing our children. In Pakistan, they have perverted more Pakistanis into Christianity since independence than in the previous 100 years of British rule. They have perverted more Bangladeshis into Christianity since independence than the previous 100 years of British rule. They have perverted 15 million Indonesians into Christianity. And by the turn of the century, they want to make Indonesia a Christian nation. There are 35,000 full-time Christian missionaries occupied in Africa at the present moment. And we say, we talk about democracy and this. All that, you are an expert. I'm telling you that this devil here is stealing my children, and I can't afford to lose one. And don't tell me that you don't know that we have lost a Muslim to Christianity. Otherwise, you are absolutely blind. In your environment, have you ever known of a Muslim becoming a Christian or not? Right, okay. Are you satisfied?
No. I'm happy about it.
We can't afford
10 who have become Democrats.
They can't. Right. So now that you change them, you keep them, save all these people from becoming Democrats. That's your job. My job is to save them from becoming Christians.
Help.
I'm going to try to save you by giving you that survival course that inshallah you won't become a Christian. That is the antidote I'm trying to give you. You know, an injection to save you from Christianity. He must give you an antidote against democratization. Okay, inshallah. Next one.
The subject is Dawah in the UK, yeah? Now let's just look at what the predominant people in this country are. How many people attend the church? Very lucky if you get 2 to 3% of the whole country attending the church. They know that Christianity is something dead, does not apply to life. Now what does? You ask anybody, whether it's in a grammar school, whether it's in a anywhere, workplace, what do they really thrive on? Freedom, democracy. For example, if they bring out a certain issue like homosexuals, on what basis would they justify it? Someone say, oh, the Bible says this. No. They will say what they got to in their own free time, in their own privacy, consenting adults, etc., is up to them. Freedom. They argue on the basis of freedom. Now, with this argument that, you know, we don't want people to become Christians, why are they becoming Christians in Pakistan? It's because the system applied allows the propagation of kufr concepts. They do not implement Islam. What is Islam? They have a distinction between deen and dunya. Islam is not practical to them. If you implement Islam as a complete system, you will see the people coming to Islam. They will see the economic system from Islam. They will see all the justices. And I'm not shirking my responsibility. I'm only here for some support from the brothers to bring out the correct call of Islam as a complete political ideology. Now, I'm not shirking any of my responsibilities. And also, I don't agree with the idea that that's your responsibility. I'm a Muslim. I have to pray. I have to do all my responsibilities. And one of them is to deliver the call to the people in the context of what Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did. So that does not mean I just say, no, I'll be specializing in doing wudu and prayer, and I won't do the fasting. No, all of it. What is known from Islam by necessity.
So what now?
So, I mean, what do you think of this idea?
I'm telling you, you are studying a certain science. You are also with the other brother. I'm sure you are also studying political science.
No.
You are well informed about, you say, the kufr system in Pakistan, Bangladesh, Indonesia, Malaysia, Egypt, everywhere there's a kufr system. So you know the system. Now you are the right man to go and give them the injection against that system. Inoculate them. No, please, don't pass the buck. You get the people, inspire the other young men like yourselves. Say, come on now, let us do an exercise. We'll have a debating society in which we're going to start, you know, debating about these things and inform the people. Go and deliver lectures. I'm sure Sheikh Razan will allow you.
I'm ready.
Go and call the people. I'm telling you now that, look, Allah is telling you, one third of the Quran is addressed to Jews and Christians. One third is addressed to Jews and Christians. Ya Ahl al-Kitab, Ya Ahl al-Kitab. Allah is crying in the Quran. He is crying in the Quran. He said, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا. And they say that Ar-Rahman, the merciful God, has begotten a son. He said, لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْءٍ عِدَّا. He said, the most abominable assertion one can make, the worst swearing you can give Allah is this. تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَتَّرْنَا مِنْهُ. At it, the skies are ready to burst. وَتَنْشَقَّ الْأَرْضُ. And the earth to split asunder. وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ حَدَّا. And the mountains to fall down in utter ruin. أَنْدَ أَوْلِ الرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدَا. That they should say that the Rahman, the merciful God, has begotten a son. I want to know, what are you doing about that when Allah is crying? When you go home and your mother says to you that, you know, this guy next door is calling me a whore, he called me a bitch, he called me a hooker. And you say, no, ma, you see, this kufr system, you know, we must change the system. Is that what you're going to say to your ma?
No.
What are you going to say? You want to break that guy's jaw? The guy's calling your mother a hooker, a whore. What do you want to do? You want to break his jaw? Mm-hmm. No? Mm-hmm. Yes, me too.
I'm restricted.
Right. So now, when Allah Bari Ta'ala is crying in the Quran, I want to know what you're prepared to do about that. He's not crying about Pakistan being run by a kufr system. He's crying that people are swearing me. Swearing Allah, and you say you love Allah more than anything else, you're not worried about that. You're worried about Pakistan and Bangladesh. I says, to hell with them all. The thing is, now Allah is crying in the Quran. I want to know what you're prepared to do about that. Come. Here. Right.
Assalamu alaikum, brother. To see you debate with the Pope. Have you ever got chance to debate with the Pope?
No, the guy's too clever. He's too clever. He doesn't want to. See, he's cleverer than most people. He's cleverer than Swagat. He's cleverer than Shorosh. He knows. He doesn't want to make a fool of himself.
But he went to Mali and asked against
That's a game. You see, he's playing. It's a game he's playing. He's a master psychologist. He's a master psychologist. Wherever he goes, He said, we must have a dialogue with the Muslims. His Holiness, the Pope. When he went to Kenya, he said that. When he went to Nigeria, he said that. When he went to Turkey, he said that. Now he said, no. When he went to Senegal, he said that. Now, what he's actually telling his people, go and convert the Muslims. But he doesn't use the word convert. Because if you use the word convert, you're going to react. Because when the priest comes along with his dog collar, you're going to chase him away. Because he's going to steal your children. But when he talks about dialogue, you can't say no. Because Allah is telling us to have a dialogue with him. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا. So yeah, you can't say no, but you'll come out second best. Because you're not trained for that. You are not trained for that. His missionaries are trained for that. So actually he's telling them, go and convert these people. They are already prepared to receive Christianity. They only need a gentle push. That's all. So that's actually what he's telling. So I caught him out. I said, right, Your Holiness, I'm prepared to come and have a dialogue with you. And it's a long story. It's a long story. The guy, he fizzled off. No, he doesn't mean dialogue. What he's talking about, telling his people, go and convert the Muslims. They're already prepared. See, they already believe that Jesus is the Messiah. They already believe in his miraculous birth. They already believe that he is the Messiah. They already believe that he gave life to the dead by God's permission. And he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. What more is required? Give him a gentle push, man. That's all. So that's what he's telling his people. It's a game he's playing. Right, my son?
Brother, you mentioned a book which you said is even more worth than Salman Rushdie's. If we don't read books like these because we don't want to publicize them, how will we know what is being printed about Islam? And if we don't know what is being printed, how can we fight against it? Thank you.
You see, it's not everybody's job. I don't know whether you bought the Satanic Verses by Rushdie. Did you buy it? Why didn't you? No. What I'm trying to say is a rhetoric question. What? How many of you have bought Satanic Verses? Please put up your hands. How many of you got the Satanic Verses at home? See? Look, in 200, 300 people, two persons got the Satanic Verses. Do you expect them all to buy Satanic Verses and read them, support the hadith? You want to support him? Because every extra book that you buy, you're supporting the guy. Do you know that? You want to do that? No. This is for the experts. The experts have a right. Jamal Badawi, or Sheikh Zahran, or Ahmad Didat, or whoever in the community, Kalim Siddiqui, these are the people, they must go out of the way to buy the book, study the book, and answer the book. It is not necessary for every Tom, Dick, and Harry, everybody to buy the book. Damn it all, what are you going to do with that book? 500 and some 20 pages, how many pounds it costs you? What are you doing? You want to go and buy that book? You want to make that guy popular? No, so in other words, I'm telling you, look, this is what's going on. I'm in the field. I'm monitoring it for you. I said, look, now for that, let's do this. Don't start making a noise. That Reverend so-and-so, Maori, he wrote this book in which he says, our Nabi didn't. Don't do that. What you're doing, you're propagating the shaitan. Then people want to know, anybody comes along with the book, you want to buy, because you have already spoken about it. You want to do that? I don't want to do that. See, Satanic Verses, I had the right to read and tell you what is there, how to fight it. Kalim Siddiqui, you must buy the book, read it, and tell you how to fight it. Right? But for each and every Muslim to buy that book, you say, you want to know what you want to know? Shit! Now that's, so you want to go into shit yourself? No, this is the doctor's job. You know, wanting to put his finger all over the place to find out what's wrong with you? That's not my job and everybody's job. Leave it to the specialist. Okay, my son? وآخر الدعوة الحمد لله.